Hi, I'm Daniel Stang with the Arizona Diamondbacks.
My name is Dane De La Rosa. I recently signed with the Tampa Bay Rays.
I'm Reifer. I play for the St. Louis Cardinals.
Kyle Skipworth. I play for the Florida Marlins.
Paul Appleby. I play for the Washington Nationals.
My name is Matt Montgomery. I play for the Florida Marlins.
My name is Griffin Murphy. I played at Redlands East Valley High School in Redlands, California. I got drafted in the second round of the 2010 draft by the Toronto Blue Jays.
Since I've been coming here since last year, I mean, statistically, it's been the best year I've had, you know, ever in pro baseball. So, last year moved from high A to triple A.
Statistically, numbers got a lot better this year. Was actually able to make my big league debut for being in shape and all that stuff because of Ian.
Before, yeah. I had a bad year in 09. I didn't have a real good, I had like a 4.8, 4.7 or something like that. And last year, I had like a 2.95, so it was a lot. EM, I think, prepared me for a better year, and it kind of put me on the right track.
My batting average went up 55 points or so, and then I ended up playing winter ball, too. And winter ball, most guys are tired. I felt like I didn't miss a beat. I was still strong. I still was in the weight room 3 days a week or so just from work ethic that instilled here at EM. And, you know, and then my winter ball, the averages was, it's the highest average I've ever hit.
I threw 160 innings, like I said, and that is just unbelievable. And I hope, I was only here a month last year. I hope with 5 months here, I could, you know, possibly throw upwards of 200 innings this year.
My name is John Daniels, trainer here at EM. Been with the company almost 4 years now. Played baseball through college my whole life. Played different positions, catcher, outfield. I also worked at USC.
Team JD. I was able to throw 160 innings. And so that's obviously a big goal that me and JD had, and we were able to accomplish that goal, and I was definitely more durable.
As far as working with a baseball athlete, they're definitely a different breed. They're obviously an athlete. We don't want to take that away from them. Like I said, I played baseball myself. But one of the biggest things as far as a baseball athlete is that we want to find a way to make them to work harder without making them feel like they're working harder. So find a way to have them do all the work that needs to be done without keeping them in the gym for 10 hours a day.
One word that I could say about EM is it's definitely been fun. Not only has it brought, you know, power, speed, endurance for me, but it kind of brings a team atmosphere when you get, you know, 5-6 baseball guys together in a room.
The group atmosphere is great. You know, you're surrounded not only by people that are athletes, but also other minor league athletes. You know, you're kind of competing against yourself. You know, you see one guy doing this, you're going to try to one-up him. You're going to try to, you know, beat his time or go up in weight, you know, because you see him, oh, he started out with 55 pounds. I started out 50s. He's at 60s. I might, you know, go to 55, 60, you know, try to do more reps, try to do more weight, try to beat his time.
The guys that we work out here in the morning, you know, the pro guys, you know, we don't let anybody slack off. You know, we get in, we get after it. You know, we do all of our shoulder exercises, core, everything. You know, nobody misses a beat.
Before EM, I was in and out of surgeries, keeping in better shape and not being injury prone.
Injury prevention, I mean, I feel like EM has everything I need.
Physical therapy, we're able to check and get a little more detailed as far as what the body needs, what each individual athlete needs. Some athletes may look the same, but on the inside of their body, their flexibility makes them completely different. You can check their alignment of their hips, of their spine, of the way their shoulders sit, the way their scap sits, and make sure that before an injury happens, it's actually a preventative measure. And instead of rehab, you have prehab, which is going to go in there, and before that injury happens, now you make sure that it doesn't happen.
At EM, you know, we don't, you know, focus all on power and getting bulky, but also flexibility. You know, flexibility is a huge part in staying healthy.
You're going to know what the major or predominant injuries are in a sport. So you look at a baseball player, you're looking at, obviously, the shoulders, very big. Especially the rear part of the shoulder. And you're talking about knee injuries in every sport. Obviously, it's a lower extremity, so you want to strengthen the muscles around the knee joint. And then the last part, too, is the core for baseball. Because there's so much rotation involved with not only throwing but hitting, and it's a matter of repetitions day in and day out, you need to make sure there's a sufficient amount of strength in both your core, is in your abdomen and your lower back.
Yeah, when I got to the Blue Jays, right away they said I was I noticed right away I was a lot more physical than all the high school guys I came in with. Not just height-wise, because I wasn't the tallest guy by any means, but I was by far the most physical when it came to the lower body. being able to run longer distances, being able to do the cardio and quick feet drills a lot better, and just general, I guess, buffness. I don't know what the right word would be, like how physical I was coming in. And they said I was, the coaches made a point to tell me that they appreciated, they really appreciated the way I came in shape, and I had nothing to say except to give it up to EM for that one.
EM has done a lot for me in the sense of I feel more athletic, I'm stronger. I come in spring training heads and shoulders above everybody else.
I've been an EM athlete since 2007, and when I signed in 2008, I was 189 pounds. I weigh myself today, I'm probably 231, 232. So, you know, in a span of 2.5 to 3 years, I've put on, you know, 42 to 45 pounds.
I've always had trouble working out. I mean, I kind of got this skinny frame and, you know, haven't really liked, you know, lifting weights. But, you know, being here, it kind of gets those competitive juices flowing with all the baseball players here. And, you know, you want to work hard.
Ball's everything. Strength, flexibility, that's one thing I was really weak at. And stretching here is a big part of it. So in order to add strength and muscle, you need to be flexible. So that's one of the things we did. Just you can't get that at other places. It's really sports specific here.
When we're talking about baseball, we want to strengthen their whole body. The problem that we have is that sometimes baseball athletes don't know how to strengthen the areas that they need to strengthen. With the athletes and the coaches that we have here, we've obviously developed a program that's going to target the areas that a baseball player needs. You talk about a pitcher, a lot of pitchers will come in and they don't feel like they need to do anything but work on their shoulder, which isn't the case. If you don't have a sufficient amount of strength in the legs, in the core, in the back, then your shoulder is going to be working a lot harder to make pitches, which means now I'm putting more pressure on my shoulder, which no matter how strong my shoulder is, I'm going to have a higher risk of injury. At the same time, when you reverse that, if you work on just leg strength, just upper body strength, just core strength, and you don't do the injury prevention in the shoulder, the rotator cuff, then you're obviously going to have a larger amount of injury or a higher percentage of injury in that joint. The other part too is obviously the elbow as well as the shoulder is one of the areas that a lot of people don't know about or don't know how to strengthen. With that, you're going to strengthen different areas, whether it be the forearm, the bicep, to minimize your risk of injury in the tendons through the elbow, in the ligaments through the elbow. Those are the two main injured areas as far as the arm goes. When you're able to now make an athlete better, stronger, faster, more explosive, they're able to take that pressure off of the areas, like I said, the joints, your knees, your shoulder, your back, your elbow. When you're able to take the stress off of that, now you're able to go longer into the games. We're talking about endurance. Baseball isn't a sport where you need to come out for one game and be explosive for 60 minutes like you would in football, or 48 minutes like you would in basketball. Baseball is a marathon.
This is the most innings I've ever pitched. So endurance-wise, I mean, there's second to none because I've never had to throw this much ever. So, and it was a tough season, but I know I couldn't have done it without EM. So
very one-on-one, you know. Like for me, I need to work on more lower half strength, you know. So sat down and talked to him. You know, other guys are only going, you know, 2 days a week heavy legs. You know, I'm going to go 3 days a week with exactly what I need for more hip stuff, you know, being a catcher, you know, and then Tuesday, Thursdays work on stabilization, you know, balance, things like that. So it's real personal, it's one-on-one, it's what everybody needs. The pitchers have their own program, I have my own program, you know, normal position players have their own program, so it's very individualized.
When it comes to performance on the field, you may or may not have an edge on the field, but after coming to EM, your advantage is that much greater. I was above all the kids in my high school when I came in. And after EM, I was able to excel past most of the kids in the area, my, you know, surrounding county and things like that.
I think a big setback that I had was durability, being behind the plate. I got injured my first full season, you know, because I wasn't strong enough, I didn't weigh enough. So I came back that offseason and was really, really went after it even more. Say, I got to play in 100 games this year. I got to be more durable. So I set that as a goal, and with EM, just working out in the offseason, I put the weight on. You know, I was up to about 210, 215. In my second full season, you know, and sure enough, I played in like 104 games. I was more durable.
I could definitely tell a difference, not only, you know, in my endurance, my speed, my strength, but also, you know, I lost a lot of body fat.
Only made one error last year in I don't know how many attempts. Able to get balls that I wasn't in the past. You know, you have to fill your position a lot as a pitcher. Getting low, some of those balls barehanded, some of them with your glove, you know, covering first base. A lot of that, I'm faster.
you know, more agile, and obviously showed.
The reason people are get better at EM is because we do functional movements. We do functional training. If I was to put an athlete on a machine, I've never once gone out to a playing field, no matter what sport it is, especially in baseball, and seen someone win a game or perform on a machine on a baseball field. That doesn't happen. You have all types of new technology. I like to call it gimmicks, that if what we did wasn't working, our athletes wouldn't be improving. They wouldn't be getting scholarships to college. They wouldn't be moving up in the professional ranks. They wouldn't be making varsity as freshmen. What we do is strictly functional. It's going to be ground-based. It's going to be them moving and feeling their own body as opposed to a machine telling them what to do. Because the bottom line is that once you get off the machine, your body still has no sense of awareness of where it's at in space for proprioception. It's not going to be able to adjust because I was strapped into a machine with a belt on my waist, with my arm strapped in a machine and being guided through a motion. If your body never has a chance to make a mistake, then you're not really reducing the risk of an injury happening. You're just making sure that it doesn't happen on that machine. When you can take the functional movement, have the arm be able to move 360 degrees, and now have a trainer there that's monitoring the movement and making sure it's done right, now you have not only your main muscles, but your secondary muscles that are going to be there for stabilization and injury prevention. Those are also going to be strengthened. A lot of times when you put on a machine, you work just your primary movers and develop strength. The way we do it, like I said, I've always said it, we're the Rocky Balboa of training. Ivan Drago was in great shape, but he lost the fight because he didn't have any type of functional movement.